In our previous lecture, we were able to analyze the individual energy within a single element. Now let's consider the total energy in the system. This can also be considered assembling the elements. So the way we're going to define the total energy, I suppose not surprisingly, is that's going to be the sum over all the elements of the energy within each element. And that's going to give us a global system like this, where we're going to have the node voltages at every node within our system times a global coefficient matrix times, again, the global nodes. Now, just to try to make this a little bit clearer, let's consider anything that is red to be global and anything that is black to be local. Now let's define what each one of these is. V is going to be all of the nodes, and perhaps there are n nodes in our system, and the coefficient matrix or the coupling matrix is going to be n by n also. So let's consider a case, for example, that looks like the truss on a bridge, like this. So we have nodes 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Those are the global nodes, and we have elements 1, 2, and 3. So let's talk about how to model each one of these in its global and local sense. Well, if I wanted to write my total energy W, that would be the sum for each one of these elements. So it would be 1/2 epsilon, and then I need to make this black because these are local, V transposed C for that element number, that's element number 1 that would be for, times V, and this would be for element number 1, plus 1/2 epsilon V for element number 2, C for element 2, V for element 2, plus the same thing for element number 3. Now, how would I define these? I certainly know how to define them. If I were considering nodes 1, 2, 3, I would be able to write that for that local element. So what I'm going to do is define a table of transformations between my global variables and my local variables. So let's consider elements 1, 2, and 3, and what are their local nodes? Their local nodes are 1, 2, 3. Let's define them here for element number 2, 1, 2, and 3, and then again here 1, 2, and 3. Let's talk a little bit about how I'm numbering these nodes. Notice that within my local grid, I'm always going counterclockwise. The global numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, can be numbered any way that you want to number them, but if they are more organized, you will end up with a simpler matrix to work with in the end. So always number your local nodes counterclockwise and your global nodes as organized as possible. Well, there are local nodes. Now let's consider what they're going to be for global nodes. So let's look at element number 1. Local node 1 is equal to global node 1. Local node 2 is equal to global node 4. And local node 3 is equal to global node 2. For element number 2, local node 1 is global node 1. Local node 2 is global node 3. And local node 3 is global 4. And now see if you can get this one yourself. So let me write out the total energy in the system for at least some of these elements so that you can see what it's going to be like. So if we considered element number 1, then we would write this as V1, V4, and V2. If we were using the global numbering, it'd be C11, C14, C12, C41, C44, C42, C21, C24, and C22, for instance, for element number 1. And that would be multiplied by V1, V4, and V2. These would be calculated using the local nodes the exact same as they were before in our previous lecture in the example. And then you would add in nodes 2 and elements 3.